Hey there, so in case you are wondering how you could create a wrinkle map system using the 3D TechArt skin PBR shader, well, there are three ways in which you could achieve that goal. It's a normal setup, basically using masks and a normal map. So that's what you'll need. So let me show you the wrinkle map first, how it should look. Let's find the category which contains it. It's here. So the wrinkle map should look probably something like this. As you can see, it doesn't have any pores and stuff like that, so it's baked directly on the low poly. The point is to have a normal map which is as clean as possible, so when you blend it with the pre-existing normal map, the general one, let's say, the basic one, it shouldn't add any other pores or stuff like that. So just the wrinkles, basically. And also, you will need masks, something like this. The way you should set it up is using a file using either RGB or RGB, whatever, or RGBA. You can also use the alpha channel as well, not necessarily just the red, green, and blue. For this example, I would just use an RGB setup. So each of these masks will correspond to a specific spot on the face where you want to enable those specific wrinkles. This is the forehead, for example. This is the middle zone, the left side and the right side of the face. So, for example, you save this file as a TIFF, and then it goes somewhere in one of these slots, right? And then you can go and connect the blend chip, the output from the blend chip, directly in this wrinkle mask inputs. And for each mask, you have four separate inputs. The RGBA, which correspond to the channels from the file. So in this case, the setup would be like the signal for the blend chip. Let's say, this middle forehead blend shape moves upwards, right? When the blend shape is at maximum, it's gonna trigger automatically this mask 5 red channel. So we can try to set up this with a simple test mask. This is the simplest way, so that's why I'm gonna begin with this type of method. Without layers, one second. So the way I said, I have it set up already. It's the fifth mask. So I just plug in that file here. One second, I need to change some stuff. Also need to reset all the controllers. Have them on zero. This is the shader. I'm gonna gonna select it from the node editor because it's simpler. So first of all, you need to have enabled the system. So be sure you have blend normal wrinkle map enabled. Don't enable the second option. This is for a different type of triggering system. Instead of mask, you can use the vertex color channel as an input, but that's for more game related stuff. For a game engine, or for example, using a plugin as fstretch as an input as a mask. So you can just ignore this. And you're gonna have to plug your normal map here. You can set the wrinkle intensity from here. So I'd want to disable this. Alright, so we have this wrinkle mask, which is this file here, which has our green and blue. So this will correspond to mask 5 R, G, and B. So if I trigger that blend shape over here, the actuator from this, from the shader, will go to 1 because the blend shape went to 1. So if I open the sculpt editor, shape editor, and view the blend shape values. One second, my eye is processing. So like this, it's a direct connection. If this value is 1, automatically this value should be 1 as well. This is very simple to achieve. You just go into the node editor on the blend shape deformer node, and you connect that specific blend shape to the corresponding mask actuator on the shader node. In this case, it would be Brawn Eraser, this one here, and goes into mask 5R, which is the one I previously showed from the selected shader. This one here, which is the file, this one, in this case the red channel, this one. So it's basically blending in the normal wrinkle normal map with the mask in this specific zone. That's all to it, basically. Another method in which you can achieve this effect using an atlas. It's a bit more complicated because you need to stitch up all the different masks, but that's useful in the scenario you wouldn't wanna actually have too many files connected to the skin shader, since that might affect performance a bit. So you should have to stitch them up something like this. In this case, it's a 16k file width and 1k width. And this setup is called an atlas, basically. So, if you want to use a system like that, you need to enable use atlas. So, if this is enabled, it will automatically disable all the connected files in the wrinkle masks areas, and it will use this single file which is defined here, so that this wrinkle atlas texture should point to this file. And you need to set up a bit this this input boxes. So the atlas style width, in this case, it's the resolution, the width resolution 16K. Actually, it's the resolution of a single box, which in my case is 512, divided by the width of the file, so 16384. In this case, it's 0.03125. 0.031. All right. And the tile height, it's obviously 512. It's 512 over 1K, 0.5. And this is the tile resolution, 512. And then you can just go and define the first tile 0. It starts at 0, the second one starts at 1. Basically, these are just the UV tiles. So the first tile would be here, the second tile would be here, and so on. And if you wanna target the second row, you just start from 0 again and add 1 here. Alright, so the setup is the same as the with the single files. It's just that you need to define where the tiles are, basically their positions. And the same thing will work the same way, basically. When a blend shape will be triggered, the actuator here, the inputs, will be triggered as well, and it will start to show that specific area where the mask is indicating. Right now it's using the Atlas system. So these are the two most common ways to achieve the wrinkle system to make it work. Another one, it's a bit more complicated. It was developed mostly for testing while I create the characters, which is the, I mentioned it a bit earlier, it's using the vertex color channel. So you could create, like, I don't know, somebody could create a plugin which detects when the skin is being compressed, and in that scenario it will color the vertex color channel with white, for example, in that specific area where the tension has been modified, squashed, for example, or stretched or something like that. And that area can be triggered by coloring the vertex color channel of the map. This is not something many people will use. For example, in my case, I use it to automatically generate all these masks, so I didn't paint them manually. They were, or maybe I just corrected a bit if I didn't like the original generated version from the plugin. But in my case, it was a good way to bootstrap the whole process and gain some time. What else can I say about the process? About painting masks, for example, you can do it in various ways. You can, for example, use Substance Painter and just open your model and paint the different masks in the specific areas where you want. You can actually use the actual blend the normal maps there and add a mask layer, and then you can export that specific mask. And you can, for example, switch stitch them directly in Photoshop, create a single file with 3 or 4 masks. It's up to the user. I try to add as many ways to configure it as possible, since it depends on the user what he wants to achieve Like for example, if you have only a few zones on the face, you don't want to go crazy using like 40 separate zones that trigger the blending of the normal map, and you have like 5 or 10 or something like that. That would make sense to actually use separate files for the masks. But if you actually want to have control over each part of the face, for example, with specific blend shapes, each should control a different mask, then I recommend using an Atlas system, since that would help the performance of the, you won't lose as much FPS. Basically, that's it. If you guys have any other questions, you can always ask me. I will try to clarify. Take care and good luck. I hope your models are awesome. Bye bye.